Okay, I was wanting to do a quick demonstration with the White's TDI on hunting and trash. Just trying to pick the high cones out of trash, like in a park setting or something like that. It would be good for coins like pennies, dimes, and quarters. Wouldn't be good for the nickels, but we'll also be getting rid of the like pull tabs and foil, bottle caps, and some nails. And even a larger iron. I'll show you a piece of larger iron. But on the TDI, what's so unique about it is it's the only pulse machine I know of where you can cherry pick high cones without digging trash. And you can do it because of this right here, the ground balance manipulation. You can manipulate your ground balance, plus you can choose your low or high tone by the conductivity switch. When you're in a high conductivity, you'll have a low tone for high conductors, and when you're in low tone or low conductivity, you'll have a high tone for low conductors. But the trick to it is, what we'll do is we're going to turn it on, and we'll set our thresholds. We can just barely hear it. And if I ground balanced this normally, where the grounds give us a positive signal, which is a high tone, so what we would do would have to keep turning this. If we went too far, it'll go to a low tone. Hear that low tone? That means we went too far with the ground balance. But what we're going to do is eliminate the high tone by going high only. So we'll flip it up, so now we don't have a low tone. And we're going to turn our ground balance all the way back over here. We'll just start off at about 2. I'll run it back down this way. And we're going to have our pulse delay set at 10, so we'll get the most depth. And I'll just leave this about halfway right here. And what we're going to do is run across some of these targets. You'll hear, look, I'm not getting no ground feedback. That's because if I turn the switch to all right now, we'd be getting the high squeal going toward the ground, but it's eliminating it, so we're not hearing it. It's not a ground balance system like a VLF meltator uses. It's just a it's not a ground filter. It's just a conductivity setting, more or less. The conductivity of the ground, and you try to get it neutral with that knob. And when you're doing that, also other targets can move around when you're changing that. But I'm not going to try to explain that. I just want to show you what we can do. I believe it was Steve Hirschbach, I believe, was the man who came up with this way of hunting a park. I can't remember exactly, but if he wasn't, he ought to get the credit for it anyway, because I believe he's talked about it before. So, and okay, here we go. Here's a pull tab. See, I don't want to hit. What we're listening for is this tone right here. Hear how that quarter sounds? Here's a dime. And here's a penny. May already mention that's an overload right here. That's an overload. So if you was hunting along and you got this, pick it up. If it does that, it's a good target. Now you're not going to be able to get your nickels, or they'll be broken. So here, see, that's in a nickel. would usually sound like this. But you're gonna find a lot of your trash will sound like that too. So here's your foil. How broken that is, you wouldn't dig that. Here's a bottle cap. These are things I thought you might find in a park, like the pull tab there. And the hear that old blood. You wouldn't dig that. Here's a nail. Another old broken. Another big nail there. Just another broken sound. Here's a big piece of iron. You know, in a park, you might not come across big iron too much, but if you do. So you would never dig that. As you can see, the corns just sound beautiful. Everything else just sounds just junky, or you don't get a report. And another thing that's unique to the TDI is the ability to see through mineral. So I'm gonna take this brick. I'm gonna grab another white MXT. I'll do a ground grab. Let you hear the quarter. Hear the brick. There's a brick. I'll do a ground grab on the brick. Then we'll lay the mineral on top of the brick. On top of the corn. That's one of the problems when you're super hot ground. But let's jump back to the TDI. And say we was coin hunting in the hot ground. I don't know where it'd be, just somewhere that just the ground was so hot that you just couldn't get coins out of it anyway. But hear that. Let me hear, let you hear the brick too. Can't hear the brick. But you can hear that quarter fine. Jump over, put the brick on top. So, no matter what ground you're in, you could still go in there and hear the coins, even under some of the worst mineral, and still wouldn't have to dig the. What happens now when you do this ground bounce manipulation like this? It kills all your depth as far. You're probably not going on a quarter, 6-7 inches, maybe 8 inches max. But in bad dirt, or if you're in a park where you just wanting to pick coins, you can do it. This is the only PI that does it, especially if it's in bad dirt. Now, if I'm over here where it should ground balance, and when you're in the all switch, if I'm over here by 8, got great depth. It's comparable to some of the, hottest VLF metal detectors made, the depth would be. So, especially the lower the conductor, the more depth this thing will get. Let me show you. If I turn it on, I got the ground balance over at 8. I'm in awe. Look at this. That's a nickel. And that's probably 16, 17 inches on a nickel. So, plus the dirt's not going to mess with it when you're running it. So it really jumps on the low conductors. But, and the high conductors will be deep too. I'll show you the quarter. It'll be a low tone. So that's a low tone. This is a high tone. So, I mean, it's plenty deep, but when you manipulate the ground box to get rid of all the trash, you'll lose some depth, as I can show you on this quarter. Now it'll be... It's probably still about 10 inches. So, I was just wanting to show you some of the ways to hunt trash with a TDI. Now this TDI here is the SL model, and it's running on the normal white battery pack, just the like they all use, the 12 volt pack. I just ordered me a 15 volt battery to go in this machine, and the reason being, it's basically a TDI big box shrunk down to fit in this box, and the big box has the luxury of using bigger batteries, and they run up about 14.8 volts, something like that. Batteries, big batteries. Well, there's a guy in Virginia, I think his name's Reed Mann. I actually just bought one from him a few minutes ago. It's a battery that fits in here, slides in. Just no modification, just slide it in. It's running on 14.8 volts, so we'll basically be running the same voltage as the big box TDIs. And the differences in these TDIs, the SL here, is you'll notice, has a super, even on look, that's wide open. How smooth that threshold is. If I turned on a TDI Pro, or just the big box regular TDI right here, it would be so noisy. The threshold would be warbling so bad. You'd have to keep it back over in about 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock to get it to, as smooth as this. And you probably still wouldn't be as smooth. But that machine has more depth. I'm not saying it's just outrageously deeper, but it does have some more depth, and it's a little more sensitive. What I'm hoping with the battery pack I've just ordered, and I'll know by this weekend, is it comparable to a big box TDI? Because I'll tell you, these TDIs, the way you can manipulate them, there's so many things you can do with these machines that you can't do with any other pulse machine. And if you can, but the other ones are so heavy, they're hard to swing all day. If you can get you a good battery pack running in this thing and get close to the same performance, you know, I'll jump up to a bigger coil if I have to get a little more depth over this one here. And it might be the best of both worlds. Keep the light weight plus get some decent depth close to. With a pulse machine, depth's not everything. It's the see-through in mineral. And when you have the ability to select what you want to dig, believe me, I've been in some bad dirt with these machines right here, around here on top of the mountains. I mean, buttons 4 or 5 inches deep. You've never heard, or you've heard them, but they sounded like a nail on a VLF machine. There's one hill over here, I can go over there and I forget, I think 15, 20 Eagle buttons, beautiful R coat button. Three ringers, J hooks, pack studs, stuff just laying all around that all the other machines were calling nails. Hunted it for years and never knew the stuff was even there, to tell you the truth. That would got a couple of three ringers out there years ago. That's why I knew to go back up there. But when I took the TDI in there, and I've taken Infinium and other machines up there, but I dug a Eagle R coat button up there. It was unreal depth. Beautiful. Had gold all over it. I mean, it was a foot or more deep in that old red chalk dirt. So, I mean, these machines here have their place. So, if I can get this new battery running in this thing to jump up the depth a little bit more, might be just the perfect pulse machine to have at the house. I mean, you can pick these things up for nothing nowadays used. So I just wanted to go ahead and share some of the things I'm finding right now. And I'm going to keep everybody updated on the battery pack, that Reed Man battery pack. I'm going to keep everybody updated on that. All right, I appreciate it.